up, get out and get something. Don't let the days of your life pass by. You need to get up.
Welcome to another edition of Vox Wednesdays. I'm Roger, the official videographer for Voices of the Struggle. And I got the motivator, the inspirator, Willie here. And today we're going to be talking about procrastination. So what is procrastination in your eyes? Man, in my eyes, it's real simple. Procrastination. Making excuses, putting something off. You really want to get something accomplished, but you're making an excuse for it and pushing it off, pushing it back, saying you'll get to it later. And I know it's like a disease. Everybody goes through it. But I feel that procrastination is something that's not a value to you. Something that you feel is not a priority to you. How do you feel that would help people, stop people from putting things off day by day? Man, you gotta look at, like you just said, man, procrastination is a disease, man. That is the number one killer of our dreams. If we don't act on our dreams now and we continue to put them off and say we'll get to them later, first of all, you're going to start losing ideas and it's going to start losing value to you. So what you think is important to you, is it really important to you or is it just a nice thought? If you really, truly believe in what you're doing, you would not be procrastinating because you got something to live for and you got something to do. For example, if I know that my mother is struggling and she's counting on me to bail her out of this bondage and this oppressed life that she's living in, I don't have time to wait. I don't have time to say, hey, let me watch this episode of Love and Hip Hop and I'll get back to it later. Nah, I gotta cut the TV off. I gotta grind right now because I got my mom counting on me. My family is counting on me. They counting on me to bail them out. They counting on me. So I don't have time to procrastinate. So if you continue to procrastinate, all you're doing is punishing yourself and you're shooting your dreams down. And how do you weigh out values and priorities? It's two different things. A priority is most important to you. It should be an emergency to you. And a value is just something you care about. A little, it could be a lot, could be a little. How do you weigh between those two things?
Man, weighing between values and priorities. It could be good and bad. Depends on how, it depends your perspective on things. If it's priority to you, for example, your breath, your next breath, that's priority to you. Your gold chain that you got on, that's value to you, okay? You understand what I'm saying? So I can live without that gold chain, but I can't live without my next breath. Look at it like that. Okay, my value, yeah, I love them. I care about them. I don't have to have them, but I want them. And they mean something to me. My priorities, I cannot live. I cannot make it without it. Your priorities should be number one. Your family, your kids, your wife, your mother. Number one to you. So your dreams, that's your priority because your life is dependent on it. You don't have time to put it off. Values, that's different. You might want that nice fancy car. But I promise you ain't gonna get that nice fancy car, that nice beautiful home, if you ain't got your priorities in place. Priorities, putting your workload first, grinding, hitting in the face, tackling in the morning, doing what you're supposed to do. Get everything in place so you can get the things that hold value to you.
Exactly right. And what do you feel like most people put off day by day? I believe schoolwork, if you're in school, getting to work on time, most people put that off. What do you feel like most people put off day by day?
Man, people put off their priorities. Like, that doesn't even make sense. Why are you being late for work if you know that that's how you pay your bills, that's how you feed yourself, that's how you clothe yourself, that's your shelter, that's how you pay your rent. We don't respect priority. But I tell jokers all the time, man, you ain't never really been through something. You ain't never really been at the bottom if you still putting off priorities. If you putting off school, you know it's school that's gonna better you, that's giving you education, that's providing knowledge to you, that's gonna get you ready for your future and your career and everything that you supposed to be doing, and you gonna put it off? It don't make sense. But I guarantee you that if your homeboy say, hey man, let's go to cookout, let's go get something to eat, you'll be the first one there. Yeah, man, let's go get something to eat. But he said, hey yo, man, let's go to the library, let's study a little bit. You can be like, let's go tomorrow. You can put it off. Then tomorrow another excuse can come up. Stop putting off your priorities, my people, because I promise you, you continue to put it off, you will never get what you're destined to get, and you will never have the values that you want to have in your life. And finally, I know you said, like, put things off for your friends. How can you adjust from saying, no, I'm going to do this right now, into just doing it and not even thinking about it?
It's all mental. It's all mental. Like, I was looking at a study the other day. You got 5 seconds before your brain changes your mind. Your brain, I was looking at a thing, man. It was telling me that your brain is designed to keep you safe. So if it's something that's uncomfortable for you, something that's something that you're not used to, your brain is going to make you change your mind. You got about a 5 second window. So when you get up in the morning, when your alarm clock goes off, and you say, oh man, you know, I'm still sleepy, I got something else to do. You got about 5 seconds before you get out of that bed, before your brain makes you change your mind, because your brain is designed to keep you safe. So, if you want to write this book and you say, I'm going to do 500 to 1,000 words a day, and it's time for you to come to write those 500 words, those 1,000 words a day, your brain will say, you know, you could be watching TV right now, man. You could be doing something else right now, because it's not comfortable to you. Because it's not comfortable. So your brain is going to push you away. It's going to push it away. It's going to push it back. Fight it. Fight it. It's all mental. Tell yourself, just like when you eating vegetables, but you know you gotta have them. You don't wanna eat them. It's even hard to swallow, but you telling yourself mentally, this is nutrients to my body. Your dreams, your priorities. Your priority is nutrients to your life, to your destiny, to everything that you're supposed to be becoming, to your diamond. I tell you all the time, remember, it's a diamond inside, and it's absolutely your job, your priority, to let it shine.
And that'll do it for this episode of Vox Wednesdays. I know you're a speaker. Tell the people how they can book you for more gigs and speak to the community.
Man, I speak to the community, I speak to schools, I speak to corporate, I speak to doctors. I had a doctor call me the other day and asking me what was my approach when dealing with the youth. Hold on, you're the one got the PhD? What you asking me for? Because first of all, can't nobody tell me how to survive the struggle, because the struggle is all I know. Now, if you want to book me to come speak to your youth, your parents, your teachers, whatever it may be, you can call me directly, 336-456-2461, and you can book me through my website. Contact us, hit the link, btcmentoring.com. Break the chain, mentoring. btcmentoring.com. Contact me, and I promise I'm going to leave whoever I'm in front of inspired and ready to go get it.
And that'll do it.
Don't let the days of your life pass by. You need to get up, get out, and get something. Don't spend all your time trying to get high. You need to get up, get out.